With me on Skype today from Circassia, I'm joined by Steve Harris. Steve, good morning.
Good morning.
Look, another box ticked here, AirNOvent, a step closer to the market with the completion of this pre-submission meeting. Steve, fill us in on the latest.
Yes, we're delighted. I mean, it was as expected. I mean, we licensed this product a couple of weeks ago. We were very aware of this meeting, but it's an important milestone to actually agree in writing with the FDA exactly what's required in order to file the product. And so there were no surprises. They haven't required any further clinical data. So we're extremely pleased. It's a good step on the way.
And this triggers a milestone payment?
Yes, so this is the final milestone payment prior to a milestone on approval. So there'll be no more funding after this. But this was anticipated. We wanted to make sure that this meeting happened before we paid essentially the full upfront amount for this product.
Well, Steve, just walk us through what the next big steps are here for AirNOvent.
Yep. So what we'll be doing is we'll be compiling the file that needs to be submitted to the FDA over the coming months. And our partner AIT have indicated that they will be filing that with the FDA at the end of the second quarter of this year. So really not very long. And then we expect approval in the first half of next year. And then we can launch the product, which will be fantastic.
And as far as the launch is concerned, of course, you've already got a sales team based in the States.
Yes, so it slots very nicely into our commercial infrastructure. And in fact, you know, because we have that sales team in place, we have effectively a fixed cost base. We'll need to add one or two people, and then the sales of that product can fall straight through to the bottom line.
And Steve, just while I've got you, of course, the first day trading on the AIM market today for Circassia. Just remind us why the move has taken place. What's the thinking behind this?
Well, it was driven because the way that free float is measured on the main market doesn't include any shareholders over 5%. And because we have a lot of shareholders who own more than 5% of the business, even though they are traditional fund managers like Invesco, they don't count in our free float as defined on the main market. So we moved to to AIM, which actually is probably appropriate for a growth company like ourselves. You know, we're looking at very rapid expansion. We're looking at business development opportunities to actually accelerate that. And in fact, that's easier to do on AIM. So it was driven by the free float, but actually there is, you know, very compelling business reasons as to why we think it also makes sense.
Have some of your shareholders, some of the institutions on board sold off as a consequence of this?
The institutions are pretty ambivalent as to whether you're on AIM or the main market. Certainly there's sorts of people that invest in companies like Circassia, but there are index tracking funds that track the main market. And yeah, there was high volume on Friday, and we understand from our brokers that was a number of those tracking funds having to sell down because we're no longer on the main market. Conversely, we would hope that there are funds that follow AIM that would start acquiring our shares. So there was a bit of pressure on our shares last week. We understand it from our brokers. That was the reason. So hopefully that pressure is now going to ease up.
But a lot to look forward to this year, Steve, as far as Circassia is concerned.
Yes, we've got some very big milestones coming up. I mean, at the end of March, we have our approval for Duaclear, which is a Nux product. We have an additional approval for Tordoza with our supplementary application to the FDA to include some data. We have this AirNOvent coming shortly after that. So we really have got a lot of very important milestones coming up, and you know, it's an exciting time.
Certainly is. Steve, thanks for the quick update. Nice to see you today.
Likewise. Thanks very much.